I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes want to see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you.
Oh, hallelujah, church. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You know, we're just going to go ahead and just come right on in there. Amen. Hallelujah. I know that our days have been misty. Amen. It just seems like we're in the mist. Come on now. The mist of the storm. But you know what? There is a beginning. There is an ending. And there is a going through that mist, amen, that mist of the storm. You may feel like your boat is sinking, amen, but God is there to rescue us, amen, to pull you out, to take you out, and to lift you up out of that miry clay, hallelujah. You know, we know and understand the day of Easter, which the world in itself, I don't know about all the world, but a good portion of the world that believes in that Easter, amen. I believe that I was looking into it and just really realizing, and it's been some years now, but you know, I never knew that, a bunny can't lay eggs, first of all. You know, they lay other bunnies. It's the chicken that lays the egg. That was already a sign of a miracle there, to think that, you know, that a bunny can lay eggs. I'm just trying to be real with y'all, church. You know, but it's all good. You know, I understand. I got grandchildren too, you know, and people get new clothes. They just want a fresh something new. But I believe that that's a sign of multiplication. Amen. Because when you think of the egg in itself, I mean, really, who can just have one egg? You know, I've never had someone say, when you eat an egg, you know, eggs are a sign of a multiplication. You know, just like having babies and having families and seeing your generation to grow, and multiplication, you know. Now I'm not going down that way. But what I'm saying is there's different signs. And I believe the world used that as a sign. Amen. For whatever reason. Now, multiplying in a good sense, and there's also multiplying in a bad sense, amen, because if you got one ant, you don't want a whole bits of fire ants everywhere that you go. You see what I'm saying? But what I'm saying, that there is the love of Christ. What I'm sharing is that, you know, the love of Christ is real. The love of Christ is there, and He is for our lives. And yesterday, for those that do go to church, knows that though that day is a day of resurrection of our Lord and our Savior, that how much He was torn and pulled and just at every aspect of His body, you know, every time it came to the crucial point, of that scene, you know, my daughter felt out of sorts. It was a part where she felt angry when they whooped him, you know. And I believe that those are feelings and emotions that we go through in life, that sometimes when we get treated unjustly, amen, we're receiving persecution for the things of Christ, you know. But also, too, it shows our character of who we are, amen, and whose we belong to. You know, he didn't say that now that you come into my kingdom, the kingdom of God, that everything's going to be, as they say, honky-dory. In other words, that everything's just going to be all right. You know, I heard a pastor say it this way, that if someone told you that, they pretty much were lying to you. If it was another pastor, well, they missed the mark. You know, because we still live in this world. Amen. And I've been sharing that all past week of every day, just putting it out there. The Christ, what he paid upon the cross. Amen. And I drove that to the point. I drove that to the point. I drove that to the point. I mean, I got about, I think, three or four, there was four or five, something like that. I don't know how many. But I made sure that they watched those DVDs with me. Amen. Those movies about the Passion, the Son of God, you know. We put in there the giants, those that went against the giants. As you can tell, I don't watch very much TV, but taking the time to see those things and sitting my children down and giving them a revelation and letting them work out their salvation within that. That was one of the things that I was sharing. And so there's a depthness, and God is good for that. God is good for you, as well as he is there for you, you know, to be open and knowing where are we surrounded and the places where we go to and the things that we do. There's an effect, church, you know, and I believe that if we add Christ in all areas within our lives, that we can see things more clearly. Sometimes there's things that we go and we do, and we just do it. And a lot of the times, maybe we do it blindly without realizing the full aspect of the whole matter of the fact. Now, there are times when the Lord leads and he guides. And I'm saying he always is leading and he's always is guiding. But I'm saying in our lives, personal lives, and every aspect within our lives. But do we always see God guide us? Do we always see that he leads us? You see the difference there? You know? Because he's not going to lead you to a place that he knows that you will fail him. You know, a beer joint, a dancing club, and you to then to act like a fool or dance like a fool. You know what I'm saying? Or someone that's going to bring you harm. You know, there's places and spaces that do all that. But to bring an awareness and to know where we're at and to where He is taking us. His name is to be uplifted. His name is to be glorified. His name is to be praised in all the earth. You know, that's the wondrous of our Lord. God gives us appointed times and appointed seasons. And this is an appointed signs of appointed seasons of new growth, of prosperity, a multiplication of what we have worked to see now manifested. And to see that is so awesome. To know that is so awesome. You know, the word of God speaks there out of the Psalms 103, praise the Lord with all of my soul, and I forget not all of his benefits. That he forgives. He forgives us of all of our sins, and he heals us of all of our diseases. Who redeems your life from the pit. He redeems us. And he crowns us with his love and with his compassion. In other words, we'll have more of Christ in God's abundance. Because that to me right there is blessing. That there to me is abundance. That in which we may have an abundance. I have an abundance of sin. Well, he forgives. There's much more forgiveness than our abundance of sin. Well, I have these diseases. Well, he can heal you. Because he heals us. There is abundance of healing for us. Because he's reminded me, forget not all of his benefits. He satisfies the desires with good things. I like to say with God things that he satisfies my soul and desires. So that even my youth is renewed like the eagles. I am reborn. I am renewed. I am restored. I have come alive into Christ, trusting in the Lord and in the power of his holy might. You know, church, God is that good. He doesn't repay us according to all of our sins. But there is a cup that overflows. The anointing that breaks the bondages. And that literally who sets the captives free. And I'm here to share with you, even here today, that God's love for you is so great. He is there to wash all of our sin and to bless us mightily, that we may continually to keep on moving forward and forgetting not all of his abundance and what he has for us. You know, sharing this reminded me how he multiplied the loaves and the fishes. And we're thinking, wow, the Lord gave the bread and the fishes for all the people to eat. But you know what? They still had to cook it. Because I don't believe they're going to be sitting there by the thousands and eating raw fish. They still had to cook it. They still had to gather their sticks, make a fire. Between the thousands that heard of him and that met up with him to see the hand of God move over and in their life. What I'm sharing with you is there are still things that we have to apply to allow that promise then to work within our lives. God works and he ministers to a heart, to our mind, to our soul, to our body. Because his word is like a medicine. It's a medicine to our lives. Amen. And he crowns you with this love and this compassion. You know, sometimes I believe that when he takes us up to another level, there's another level of kindness. There's another level of goodness. There's another level of mercy. There's another level of grace. And someone can think, okay, that's it. That's it. You know, I've came to my mark. I've came to my place. But then when we began to bow the knee more and more and more, we realized that there's still more of Christ that needs to be expressed. And believe me, if the enemy can continue to squeeze until there's nothing out, I believe that's the plan of God. Because when there's no more squeezing, that means there's no more of me. And there's more of him within me. That it's not about me. That it always been about him. You find yourself empty to be full. You find yourself to be vulnerable and open to be filled. You find yourself in places and spaces or you just don't know. But his presence is always there. He is our help. He is our Savior. He is our lover. He is our giver. He is our sound mind. He is our love. He is our compassion. He is our goodness. He is our kindness. He is our joy. He is our peace. And still in all, the God of the universe, he says, forgive them. Forgive them. In his mind, he could have been warned. Well, weren't these the people that I fed? Well, weren't these the people that I healed? Well, weren't these the people that I delivered? That were demon possessed? Or that were blind, that could not see? Or the lame that couldn't walk? Or those that couldn't hear yet? To hear them cry out, crucify. for him to even know, as they called him, this is the Messiah, this is the King. He said, it will not be done like this. In other words, his appointed time had not yet to be shown. But others were beginning to receive that revelation. But all he was doing and all that he was asking as well as applying that application, the life of Christ. He said, this will cause a war. This will cause a riot. What he's seen as a praise offering unto the Lord, others had seen as a riot. Others had seen. Others had seen not only as a riot, but just being amiss and abusing the systems. Others saying, you are breaking the law. You're a blasphemer. But yet he was just doing the work of his Father. The work of heaven here on earth. So I guess I'm acquiring unto you today that what is it? What is it? Is all well? How is our heart today? How is our life today? Are we open? Are we being challenged to let more of God in? Put God first. And then all these things shall be added unto you. Amen. Well, church, God bless you. We love you in the name of the Lord. And thank you for tuning in with me, Cruzando Fronteras con una voz alerta. I want to thank you as well for your prayers. I believe I've just came out of the depths of the earth myself. God was working me through some great and mighty processes. And I'm gathering my strength and gathering the word in which he has given unto me that I could help in blessing and help in supplying what God has not only for you, but also for me. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, he has me into the school of the prophets at this time. So I'm taking more time and dedication time into the reading of the word and in prayer. Definitely in prayer. And I'm seeing new things. Amen. Aspects in my life. Sometimes I feel like I'm not doing much. But when I begin to do all the things that are required of everything, I say, yes, I am doing a lot. So we love you. We thank you. And we will see you so very soon. Hey, don't forget to visit the website, www.cruzandofronterasfrontinternet.com. Amen. God bless you, church, and have a wonderful day. Amen. Amen.
Be the only Jesus. Introducing Jesus.